Yeah, I need to take my nose mask off, but everybody is wearing it, you know. Social distancing, as you can see. Hey, so thank you very much for checking me out. My name is Eko Simpson. I'm in school right now with my teachers. Let's have a conversation. I told you that I'll be doing more videos concerning our culture, and then you can also be teaching me or us your culture. So that when you come here, you wouldn't have that cultural shock to say, oh, I thought things must be done the way we do it in the state or whatever. So today we're going to have a conversation, very deep one, when it comes to parenting and then children here in Africa. There is this miscommunication, miseducation, whatever that I have to come in with, that says that your parents expect you to take care of them when you grow and get a job. We are made to understand that, I mean, growing up, parents take their children as insurance during the old age. Insurance as in, hey, I'm taking care of you, and when you grow up and get a job, and I'm old and I can't work, you have to come and take care of me. That has been like the norm in the African settings. So me right here, with my teachers right here, we think that as we are working now, we are supposed to take care of our parents. And dare you not to do that. They will call you, call your family members and say, hey, my son is not taking care of me, and blah, 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 whatever. So today we're going to have a beautiful conversation with my teachers. They will share their thoughts on that idea. We're going to mix the English, the pidgin language, and then our local language, Fanti. So hey, enjoy this video and put up a comment. Let me know what you also think in your country, in the Caribbean, USA, Canada, Japan, China, yes, wherever you are watching us from. Let us know. Is it compulsory for you to take care of your parents when they grow old and you are working? If you don't do that, do they come at you and say, hey, why are you not taking care of me and all that? So let's go to the teachers and have this conversation.
Welcome to Cape Coast.
There, my old man, missing him, Robert Matheson, for man who being in Wabay in pain. Osana, I find him some at his own wish.
I will base mine on being a Christian. I would have to, together with my husband, would have to train our children in a Christian way so that when they grow up and then get a job to do, they would have the responsibility as a Christian to come back and then take care of us. So I do not expect my children to grow up and take care of me. Maybe my husband and I have saved a lot so we can take care of ourselves. But in the other way, as a Christian, like I said, I train my children to learn to also serve when they grow up.
Growing up, I think when we visit our grandma, they would always say, or she would always say, "Where you paying for no one your scar? One more thing, like when you grow up and you are working, earning money, remember us, as in, bring something at the end of the month, because when you were a baby, we carried you, we bathed you, so you should also reciprocate in that form." And back in the house too, my mom or my dad would always give an example, not emphasize, but we'll give an example that, oh, this person's child, as in, when he started working, when anytime you visit, he brings something to the house with the notion, with the mind that you should also understand that when you also start working, you should do likewise.
Well, you see, I grew up in the hood, you know, so in the hood, you are taught to be responsible. This is your family. And wherever you go, you should come back to the family and come and take care of the family. You are consciously trained there. You should go find something out there and come back and take care of your family. So even though parents will be, I mean, my parents, for instance, but indirectly, you are not sure that you are not. And all that until you grow up, okay, fee. So it's more like you are indirectly cautioned to go out there, try make it in the right way though. then come back and take care of the family.
So, like the others have said, it's not that the parents will directly tell you to take care of them when you are working or you are they are grown. But you being a child, growing up, you are now working and all that, it is just right to take care of your parents when you are in a position to do that. But they will not directly tell you, okay, I'm looking after you, I'm taking care of you for you to grow to a certain level. Then you also start looking after me. They don't say that. But you have to know that it becomes like your responsibility. Because when you were a child, they didn't abandon you, they took care of you. So if they are also now grown and are unable to work, at least also there was so it's actually.
Okay, due to my opinion be say the man say you give birth to a child as your papa makes you grow, when she get job they do. There's a saying that say Michelle or like if your mom pop you as you be kidina. You grow up, but you do for proper mom, make in teeth come out. So maybe to my opinion be say, as a pop you grow up, you become somebody in future, as you work. You for pop me as mommy or father.
But at a point where you are not able to take care of them, you know they attack you and say, and you are not taking care of me, you are not building houses for me, buying me cars. What is our reaction to that?
Well, I haven't had that experience yet, but even if they do, I think we should agree at a point. Today, most of my you're starting a year can already know how. Genuinely, you'd want to kind of pay back. You paying back will be like, okay, it's a minya BBA, almost a wonder, then let me share with them. But say if parents and uncle some permit straight away, baby some why there, brother I'm not sure why I'm going to be able to them uncle some why. I think that in our setting, only prudent, there I will be harsh on them. I would have to tone down, try to apologize, accept it, and then change my attitude towards them so that peace will prevail in the house.
You realize that. Now, I know most of my teachers are married, they have kids and all that. You have to take care of your nuclear family. You have a wife, at least two children. You need to pay your house rent, electricity and all that. So don't you think parents should allow us to also take care of our kids instead of expecting that? I mean, I know most of us are saying parents don't expect us. They, you know, inculcated that into our growing up. But yes, they still expect you to come and take care of them. But you also have family. So what do you do?
Some of the parents, well, not all. Some are quite understanding. So when you're married, they begin to minimize the pressure. Unlike previously, when you're not married or something, they know you're not married. They know you don't have any responsibility. So your money is intact, and they can fall on you at any time. But when you get married, you begin to have children, they know you have to take care of your family. So some become more understanding. Others also feel once they have taken care of you, you should also do something. That is where the pressure begins to mount on you and it becomes something you're unable to.
And then you go for loans.
You go for loans.
Okay, so, you have your own children. You started a nuclear family. And then your parents are expecting, as the other colleague said, some parents, they understand the season. So now you are starting a nuclear family. So some parents wouldn't be asking you as an attacking. And you also have other parents, you know, putting pressure on you. Like, last month, it didn't come home. And then, you know, so in this case, we have two parents, let me put it that way, who understand seasons, will not put pressure on you, but understand the season, the change. And others too wouldn't. They expect that they go for a loan, sacrifice, or put them first, family first, before you think about any other person. Today, just like what we were saying, when you are, they are training you, they expect that you should grow up and take care of your family, the family that you will start. But along the line, just like what my colleague said,
they will be expecting something. I remember one time, an auntie of mine, what do I use my money for? More like she's trying to say she's not seeing me giving them money, so when the month ends and I get my kuli, what do I use it for? And I got furious, I got angry. I don't understand why she should ask me that. And in any case, she was not even the one who took care of me. So I didn't even understand why she should ask me that question. But they expect that you should look back and just take care of those who are behind you. So obviously, they expect it. But just that they don't actually push those words in your ears that go there and come back and take care of us. So obviously, they expect something. But just that they don't want to say it. Some families do. Our society is such that if you have money, if you are living well, and your parents, when the society itself will even look at you with a certain eye, which means that you've been trained to know, Emma, what to tell there, this will be my responsibility. If my parents are not able to take care of themselves, I have to do it. That is how we are brought up. And she said, When you are able to make it in life now, you neglect your family. Even the society will look down upon you, no matter how successful you are. So it is more like a responsibility or an obligation on you. If you have succeeded in life, then you have to take care of them. But say, who parents, they are.
If my parents, them they work, them get money, everything. They don't go beat me, say, why say man catch? I don't feed them. Nah. Now I know go happen. If I don't take them part, me now, me subway, maybe my friend know they come where. Then go feed pop me, Rambo. So I think say, those where my parents know they work, you know, they be the people where them go demand say every man for give them something. So if your parents know they work, I don't demand, you forgive them something. That one, if they know they work there, it become a shed amount. It be must. Say for that one. Well, like so, if we did when a parent and my man say, and then a banner say the next day, a man, they for no say, need to be on a blank one bed. The next day,
okay, so the conversation has been interesting. Everybody sharing his or her opinion on whether we are obliged, mandated to take care of our parents when they grow. Some people were like, okay, when they are old and they are working, then you don't have a lot of work to do. But if they are old and they are not working, then it is a must for you to take care of them. So, hey, thank you very much for checking us out. This is my school. She is a mother, so she's our mother right now. Mommy, give me five.